Good afternoon and welcome to today's Daily Market Update. My name's James Hughes, Chief Market Analyst at Alpari UK. We're going to look at the major stories moving financial markets so far today. And on this Monday, we're looking at the European stress test, banking stress test, which have been released first thing this morning today, and just the repercussions they're having on the markets and just how relevant they are to the banks and the current financial situation that we see ourselves in at the moment. Now, we saw 130 banks were tested, and out of those 130 banks, 25 banks failed those stress tests. Now, out of the 25 that failed, we've seen 12 have already improved their capital position and are now in a much better situation. But a lot of the reason why we're seeing 12 of those having already made the difference is that these stress tests were done in December 2013, and it is only now in October 2014 that we're actually getting the results of these. So that's one of the questions that's been raised as to why are these taking so long? And in fact, are they actually still relevant, the results of these tests, since we're talking 10 months has gone by? And of course, not just 10 months has gone by, but so much has changed in terms of the economic standpoint and the economic picture and the corporate picture for a lot of these companies. So, with 25 of them failing, that's one point out of it. But still, there's a lot of these banks which are passing. So overall, we're seeing this really being bought as a more positive story rather than a negative one. Okay, 25 have failed, but as we say, 12 have already made those capital requirements up again. And in total, we were talking 31 billion euros worth of capital requirement was needed to be put in. However, there's a lot of stories being talked about why maybe these stress tests aren't necessarily too relevant. And one of those is the deflationary news. Now, the head of the EBA has come out and said that deflation wasn't taken into account when looking at the banking stress test because it doesn't see that as one of the biggest fears for these European banks. However, anyone who's been looking at the economic picture around the Eurozone, anyone who's been looking at any numbers for the past couple of years will know that deflation is the single biggest issue that we have in the Eurozone economy at the moment. So for that not to be included in the stress test because they don't deem it to be relevant, then that brings up a lot of questions that need to be answered as to why that wasn't brought in. We've seen inflation fall from around 3% to 0.3%, and we're still struggling. The ECB, Mario Draghi, are still trying to fight to bring this deflation, this inflation figure higher and get that fear of deflation out of the way, which has been hanging around for such a long time now. So the deflation story is one of those. Now, just when we see these European stress tests, and we've seen them a number of times, of course, since the banking crisis, but they always tend to come out as a more positive result. We usually see more banks than not fail, and we usually see it taken out as a more positive story. So there's a lot of talk around it that seems to be some kind of a PR story to try and boost people's expectations of these banks, boost the sentiment when people are looking at lending and various different points, look at the investment side of things and boost those. So it's almost seen as a bit of a PR story that the majority of them do pass. But as we've said already, the fact that these tests were done in December 2013 and we're now in October 2014, that's 10 months for a lot of things to change in terms of the actual status of these banks and their financial position. So the European stress tests have caused a bit of an issue this morning. We're seeing markets not necessarily a lot lower. We're seeing them pretty much treading water, the major European markets to the downside. But then again, that's not too much of a surprise. After last week, we saw the biggest amount of gains in a single week for equity markets. So it's for 2014. So it's not too much of a surprise we're seeing a little bit more negativity today. Now, moving on through the week, we've got a lot of data coming out. We've got the headline, of course, is going to be the Federal Reserve, the two-day meeting that starts on Tuesday, the announcement coming on Wednesday. And of course, the discussion has been, since the markets have seen that little bit more volatility, we've seen quite a big fall in terms of equity markets, that discussion is around what we will see in terms of the quantitative easing. Is it too early to withdraw that QE from the US economy? There's been some officials saying that, yes, it's too early. We should look at extending that. There's been other Fed officials coming out saying, no, we absolutely have to stick to the timeline, stick to what we said before, and look to raise interest rates coming into the spring or summer in 2015. So with those sort of split opinions from within the Federal Reserve, then it makes the next couple of days and the announcement that's going to come out a very interesting one, just to see exactly what they do, the FOMC, the Fed, around this quantitative easing situation. And that's the big story. In terms of my view, I think if you look at the situation that we're in at the moment, the last few weeks we've seen pretty big falls in terms of equity markets. We've now actually seen some of those really recouped, and we're back coming back towards levels from before. But the issue is, when the markets were falling, they were falling on stories that were no different. They were falling on stories that had been circling around for the last 3, 4, 5 weeks or so. So fundamentally, in terms of the economy, nothing has changed today as it was about 3, 4, 5 weeks ago. So the situation 3 or 4 or 5 weeks ago was, let's end this quantitative easing program in October, and let's look to raise interest rates in the spring of 2015, potentially, and maybe a little bit later than that. So with nothing necessarily changing, I don't see a reason for us to change in terms of what the Federal Reserve are going to do. However, we could be surprised and we could get something. But of course, it means the next couple of days are going to be very interesting in terms of the market. And no doubt that FOMC meeting and the Fed press conference after that is going to be a real key point during the week and the biggest bit of economic data this week. For more news and analysis, go to alpari.co.uk/newsroom. Thank you very much for listening. My name is James Hughes, Chief Market Analyst at Alpari UK.